Hey guys, what's up? Today is Wednesday, and you know what we do every Wednesday.
You're here with S&M
Inspo. Wow, what do we have today?
Oh, we got chili.
Hey,
Three bean chili.
Woo. Three bean chili.
Let's go.
With our dance. Hey.
What's up, you guys?
Wow. We're gonna get started.
All right,
can you hear us, guys? Where's our mics?
Up,
we need our mics.
How you doing? Yes, because I was busy today. So next week you'll hear us a lot better than you do right now. For sure.
Share. What's up, Paul?
See you. Thank you for logging in to S&M Inspo. Hey.
So we're gonna get started.
That's right. On the three
bean chili.
Chili. I don't know why I keep saying black chili.
And she always, you know, she's vegan, so it's three bean vegan chili.
That's right, vegan. Yes.
She gets one today.
I get it.
Okay, so I first have to put a tablespoon of oil in the pan.
That is olive oil, virgin olive oil. How many of them? Okay.
So we're gonna fry up the onions first, okay?
We're gonna saute the onions, and it's gonna be spectacular. That's right. So I cannot wait for this aroma. George is going to eat good today. That's right. We're gonna make sure that he's on the other side salivating to this aroma right here. And I can already smell.
Yeah, they're burning my eyes,
the
guys.
The aroma of the onions, which is awesome.
Hey, Marcella.
Marcelo. How you doing?
So it's really good to see you. Oh, that's much closer. Thank you. Yeah, much closer. And those onions are already starting to cook.
Yes.
They're cooking. They're burning my eyes.
Woo. But it's okay.
So we're going to cook that for a minute, right?
Hey, what's up, Freddie Andriano?
Hey, Freddie. So, okay, that's right. Cooking for a minute.
So we're going to cook it for 3 minutes, actually. So you want to saute those onions for 3 minutes. And then we're going to put in the 2 cloves of garlic and 1 red chili.
Okay. So we're not doing chili because I can't take spicy, guys.
Yeah. And
DJ Marcelo, Batman Brazil.
Hey, Batman Brazil.
Yasmin, what's up?
Oh, Freddie said he's ready for his
he's ready for some
vegan chili. Oh my goodness, these onions, and look at the garlic again.
Fresh garlic, guys.
Fresh garlic. Can I tell you, like, this looks perfect. This looks like professional stuff right here.
So what I want to tell you guys regarding the beans that we're using, they are canned, but you can use fresh beans out of the bag and cook them, but you know you have to soak them overnight. But this is quick healthy meals. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna rinse the beans, and that takes the sodium off. That's some of it, at least.
Hey, yeah. Susie, so we want to make sure it's really healthy.
Yeah,
is that Susie Proctor? It is. Woo! What's up, girl? How you doing?
So the onions, and we cook for, like, with the onions and the garlic, you gotta cook an extra 2 minutes.
Ah, there we go.
Let that savor. Oh my God, it smells good.
There we don't go. Okay. So
okay.
We're trying to hook up the music, y'all. You know, so we can, because there's nothing like the aroma, the whole ambiance of music and food. You know, every time we go to a restaurant, that's what you get. Music and food.
What's that song, Amore? We use that for the Italian
the
food, though,
big
didn't
pizza
we?
Pizza by, like Amore. So guys,
okay, so what else do we add now?
So now we gotta add 3 peppers, the yellow and the red.
Okay, guys.
And for 5 minutes. Cinco
red.
Minuto, okay? So make sure you have your watch, okay?
Yellow.
And they're so pretty too and tasty when you cook them. But they're really, the peppers taste good even if you eat it raw, like I do. And it's great. But today.
Yeah.
I don't like them raw, but that's okay.
I like them on the grill with some olive oil, and they taste really good.
Oh, wow.
What's up, Susan?
Susan!
Enough sexiness.
Hey. So, yes. Oh my goodness, look at that. It's so pretty. And
so we have to cook that down. Them onions are killing me for like at least 5 minutes.
Woo! I'm trying to get your ambiance.
Now these peppers we cut them really big. You can see that, guys, really big.
Oh!
But by the end, I have sauteed down.
Oh, can I tell y'all how good this is smelling? Oh my goodness. I don't even think I could wait for the rest of the meal to be made. I mean, honestly, that is how good it is smelling up in here. Can you smell when S&M and Spire are cooking?
Okay, so what is it saying on this page right here?
Okay, hold on.
The other one that's right here.
We got the zucchini.
Okay, so now the zucchini, guys.
Yeah, we got zucchini.
Zucchini.
Zucchini all cut up nicely. She really cooked that up.
So how long does that cook for? 5 minutes?
This is not too much. Not too much.
5 minutes, guys.
Okay. So single minute, and let me tell you, it is.
Can you see the steam?
Can you see the steam? But it smells amazing. Hey, cousin Helen, what's up, girl? Oh, I got the music ready. You ready? You can go rock and freak. Mr. Rich Wilson, how are you doing on this lovely Wednesday? That's right. We are cooking up the 3-bean vegan chili. So
do we need to add the spices in yet? What does it say right here?
Okay, this one.
So after the 4 minutes of it steaming and cooking up, then we're gonna add the spices.
1 tablespoon of cumin and 1 tablespoon of coriander.
I've never used coriander so much, guys. This is coriander. You can get the fresh coriander in the bottle. Your ground cumin, and my mom loves paprika, so we got the smoked paprika, guys.
Smoked paprika. And then we're gonna use a half teaspoon of that and a teaspoon of black pepper, okay?
That's right. What's up, Mr. Rich?
Yes.
You like the flowers in here? Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, Frank Lovejoy. I know you're back to work now at Hunter's. Exercising, really, and then you get to eat.
Hey,
oh, I'm so excited. So I'm not supposed to stir it too much. So, guys, what we're going to talk about, it was so cool yesterday. I don't know about you guys, but it was in the 70s for us, and I was cold. I had to wear a jacket. So we decided what we're going to talk about is the flu, guys.
That's right.
How to stay away from it, how not to get it.
Yes.
Okay?
So we want to prevent the flu. Nobody wants to get sick around here. Nobody feels good when they get sick. So let's just stay away from it, right?
Okay, while you're talking, you got 4 minutes. I'm gonna rinse the beans.
I got 4 minutes to talk about
the beans. And let's say what beans we're using.
So we're using
kidney beans. And we're gonna rinse them all.
Black beans, frijole negro, okay? And pinto beans.
And you have to rinse them, guys. Rinse the beans. You gotta get rid of that sodium.
Thank you, love our music, hey! That's my family, hey! Thank you for the compliments, we love you guys! So again, we don't wanna get sick. So number one, even before I read these cards, vitamin B12, vitamin C, echinacea, okay? And your multivitamin every day. Okay, okay, and also, you know, it's really, really important when people sneeze and cough and all that other stuff, little droplets just fly all over the place. So now, everybody should be wearing their masks still because, of course, we wanna make sure you keep your germs to yourself.
Yes, guys, cover your mouth when you're sneezing, when you're coughing.
That's right.
Hold your shirt up and sneeze inside
like
it, guys.
All in there. I told my kids, I'm like, put your
yes, oh my God, I learned so much today. We're looking up this, okay? It's crazy.
So, because all of that can travel up to 6 feet. 6 feet! Okay? And then people are contagious about one day before they become symptomatic. So can you imagine, like, you don't even know you're feeling no good and next day you wake up like, I can't breathe. Right? I mean, I've done it and I can't in my ears and all that other stuff, okay?
I'm not trying to get sick.
Yeah, so we've been doing really good. So, and if you're sick, yo, for real, stay home.
Stay home.
Don't go nowhere. Don't be infecting other people. Nobody wants to get sick.
No, nobody wants to get sick.
Nobody.
And I'm not taking the flu shot. I don't want to get sick.
Nope.
I'm not taking. Stay home.
Yeah, we are both in agreement. No flu shot. We're not taking any shots. Well, maybe a shot of Patrol. No. Who? I didn't say that. So, yeah, but for real. Okay, and let me see. First line, yeah. Stay away from everybody sick. If they look like they're sick, their eyes look sick, stay away from them. Keep them away, all right? Let's see.
Plus, if you can commit a crime, it's easy to blend into the crowd if you wear a mask.
You know what?
Call your trip.
Okay, also touching fingers. Fingers. You can get, just by touching things, you know what I'm saying? So, like, wash your hands.
Wash your hands.
20 seconds.
20 seconds with some soap, guys.
Sing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Sing Happy Birthday.
Whatever.
Sing something, okay?
Yep.
It's good for the soul anyway. Okay? And, yeah, touching. So, you want to wash your hands all the time. So, I know since this pandemic, I've been a real crazy hand washer.
My hands are real dry.
I think I've washed off all of my good germs. Okay? Now, flu germs live on surfaces for about eight hours,
guys.
That's a long time. If you don't ever go to work for 8 hours a day, so if you combine that into money, let's say it's $100 an hour, that's $800. So can you imagine, that sounds like a lot, I mean, for one day, right? But check it out. 8 hours is a long time, that's what I'm trying to say. So please, just stay safe. Let's see. And, oh, don't try to wash your hands with just water. That's not going to work. You need soap.
That's right.
You need to wash with soap, because, you know, some people, they like do this and all that other stuff. That's not good. Okay, and paper towel. Now, I go to some people's houses and they don't have paper towel in the bathroom. I'm not gonna say no names or nothing. So,
what's up, Hell Joe's? How you doing?
That's my cousin.
Okay.
So what I do when I go to people's houses that don't have paper towels, but I'm not saying any names, I just wait my hands
in the air until they dry. Blow dry.
I do this.
Okay.
Oh my goodness. Okay. So, yeah, just wash your hands first thing whenever you go into a place, any establishment, okay? Also, hand sanitizers is not as effective as washing your hands. Hand sanitizers is like...
If you don't have nothing else.
If you don't have nothing else.
You can't wash your hands, use hand sanitizer.
Yeah, but wash your hands. And cover all food and drinks when in public places.
Yeah, guys, when you're going out now...
If you go out, because you should be staying
home. If you go to the bathroom, you cover your drink... Go to the bathroom, wash your hands, whatever you need to do. I'm going
to
do it now.
I'll take my
read
drink
that.
To
What's
the
up,
bathroom?
Danielle?
I take my drink to the bathroom. I'm one of those. I'm like, I'll be right back.
Really?
Well, I drink it on the way.
Well, if you're out to eat dinner and you're sitting at the table, cover it. Yeah. I'm going to start that.
And open your windows for 20 to 30 minutes.
Yes. Open your windows to let the fresh air in your house. Get out the stuff.
Yeah.
20 to 30 in the wintertime, you know?
Because there's a lot of germs. Germs are everywhere. They just like, attack. They're like, I'm going to attack you.
Okay.
So flu viruses cannot be live in high temperatures. I do not believe that, because it's hot as hell in Florida and people still walking around sick. So I'm gonna throw that one out, okay? Because the heat does not kill anything. Like
on your pillows and stuff like that.
Okay,
you know?
Like if you're drying
like if you've been sick and you don't want to get sick again, put your pillows in the dryer on 20 minutes to kill the germs and bacteria.
That bad boy in the garbage. Go get another pillow.
Okay. Well, blankets. You know, after you've been sick, you should always wash everything that you've been on or touched or anything like that.
Yeah. And so, wash your blankets every week anyway.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, because all that dead skin and stuff. So dryer, high temperature, stuffed animals, all that other stuff. And using a humidifier can help create a more inhospitable
atmosphere. That's right, guys.
But in Florida, it's so humid in here, you're going to have mold all in your house. I'm just saying. You're going to have a lot of mold. Okay. But humidifiers work. When I lived in New York, that's what we used.
Okay, it's time to add the seasoning.
Ooh, boost your immune system. Go outside even if the weather is cold, with a jacket and a sweater and some earmuffs and some gloves and some boots and your long johns. Okay. Again, you need that vitamin D, y'all. Get the vitamin D. It's a serious thing. Everybody's downplaying vitamin D, but it's serious, and you need it to help boost the immune system. Look at all these beautiful
colors. So now we're going to put in the black pepper, the coriander, the cumin, and the smoked paprika. That's what's up.
Okay. And you want to sleep, because a lot of people don't sleep. You sleep between 7 to 9 hours a day, you're good, because your body has to rejuvenate. And it doesn't if you're awake, because you're so busy and you're ripping and running. And I'm guilty of ripping and running. So I need to sleep more. I'm trying. I don't know. Do you sleep? How many of you guys sleep? We're going to talk about sleep another time.
Okay, let's see. Ring my bell, Mr. Rich Wilson.
Thank you for loving our music.
Woo! Okay, what's going on with this? What else I need to put in?
Sorry. I got so... Oh my goodness, that smells good though. Where'd I put it? Uh-oh.
Right here. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Then, after that, we have the chopped tomato, the salt, the beans, and some honey. Yeah. Smoked paprika. You love that too, right? I found out about that a couple of months ago, and that's my secret ingredient, and now everybody knows.
Hey, the Montrose Fowler,
how you doing? What's up? Let's see. So she is, oh my goodness. So yeah, she's stirring that all around.
And we're gonna add the beans.
And the beans. Oh, this is good stuff, man.
So guys, I rinsed the beans off.
Look at
so
that.
So now I'm gonna put them in.
Look
here.
Look at how colorful they are. And guys, you want to drink a lot of water. I always tell everybody, we are certified personal fitness trainers, and you want to drink your water, you want to drink half your weight in ounces daily. That's what you want to do, okay? That's what you should be doing. So do it. And you know what I do? I just, when I'm here, I just go and get a cup of water and just drink it, and then I'll drink it again. Or you can set your alarm. You know, because everybody has celly, so you can go ahead and do that.
Oh, I'm glad you're fine. She stirs in the box. You already know. Mark Jackson, hey, what's up? How you doing?
That's my brother from another mother.
Okay. Okay, so after we put that in, how long do we let it cook?
I don't know.
Are we gonna put in the honey? Cause sometimes, you know, we add our own different things to here.
I don't think I want sweet.
You don't want a sweet
chili? What do you guys think? Do you like sweet chili or do you like chili?
Oh, we're doing good, Demetrius.
Oh, my brother from another mother said, save me some.
So now we're gonna let it cook at least for about 10 minutes. What are we running on time? So we got time. So people have been asking us, guys, we love your cauliflower. Can you just make cauliflower rice? And I'm like, really? So you wanna know how to make cauliflower rice. So what I'm gonna need to do is get a cauliflower out.
We're gonna do it? Oh, guys, we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. As soon as she finds it, we're gonna do it.
I don't see it.
Oh, Paul Cabanero said hot sauce and honey. And Mr. Rich says sweet honey chili. And yep, Mr. Rich says, please add the honey, honey. Okay, honey. Do it.
Okay, we'll add some honey because everybody's like, add the honey. So we took a vote, and there was no votes for no honey except for us, and we're two, and you guys are the majority, so you win. So
what we're gonna do, I think we're gonna have some. Some without honey for her, and then I'll add some honey for me. So what's up, Janet? Hope you're making this recipe at home.
Hey, Janet, what's up, girl?
Three bean vegan chili, guys.
I miss you, Janet.
Raj, you are hyped. Yes, she is.
Always.
So guys, I think somebody hijacked the cauliflower.
Oh no.
It's not. I looked in the refrigerator.
It's somewhere. So we're having a cauliflower missing moment. Oh, well, wait. I think it's here.
It was behind the, what is that stuff that you dip your chips in? That's what it's saying.
I'm coming out.
Yeah, it finally made it out.
Oh my goodness, I think I just wet myself.
I wet yourself.
Oh, you wet me.
I wet her.
Oh, the music got you dancing, Mr. Rich.
That's right. So guys, with this cauliflower, Let me not cut myself on here.
Please don't cut yourself.
I usually use some scissors. Just rip it open. Bam. So guys, there's our famous cauliflower. So I have to rinse it off first.
You gotta rinse off the cauliflower. I stepped on the stalk. So she's gonna rinse off the cauliflower because again, every time you have any fresh vegetables or fruits, you should always rinse them off. Or me, I'm kind of, well, this is, it's cauliflower. Or you scrub it off. Rinse, scrub, but rinse it off. And rip it, rip it, rip it. Oh, Mr. Rich worked all night. And now I got you like cafe con leche. I got you up and ready to go.
So guys, you have to take off the leaves off the back of it.
And she has gotten very good at this. Let me tell you, because when I went home and I did that, I was like, why does she make it look so easy? So.
All the leaves off the back.
She's a pro. She's
now some people cut this out, but I feel easier for me to just cut it halfway and then get it out.
That's where I messed up. I try to cut the thing out.
Okay.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. Would you believe? Houdini.
So they're called Florence. Little Florence.
Florence.
Yeah. So Florence. You have to break them up really tiny, guys, because I have a food processor over here.
Thank you so much.
Well, let me cut that down. It seems like it's really cooking.
Yeah.
Wow, yes. So what I do is I chop them, I slice them like this. And then I slice, can y'all see me, guys?
Can you see me? Yeah, I can see you. Okay. Can see you. Look at you.
So I'm slicing them really thin. You could use a grater like when you grade cheese, or you can use a food processor, which thank God my mom, I didn't get rid of her food processor because the one I have is like really tiny and it would take a very long time to do. So I put the Florence in the little bowl because I'm going to take them over to the food processor, which I'm going to bring the camera over to the food processor so you can see how that works. Okay, guys, let me just cut up some more. I think my mom wanted to use the other half, so I'm going to save that for her.
Get me the plastic right here.
Okay, so I'm going to put it back in the plastic for her.
So let me tell you something. The texture is, I think, if you're comparing cauliflower to broccoli, I believe broccoli is more crumbly than cauliflower. And so the consistency is
more crumbly, you think?
I think it's more, yeah, because we would have had green all over here.
Okay, so we're going to scoot over to the food processor right here. Right here. And I'm going to take off the top. I'm going to let Mirage do that. And I'm going to put some of them in there right now.
And this food processor is very quick.
Yes.
So if you have one, it's great. If you don't,
grate it or use a smaller one. So we're going to start it. Put it in. Let's see. Let's see what happens. Y'all see that, guys? Now, in the food processor I have, it takes a lot longer. It takes me like maybe 15 minutes, guys.
Because it's smaller. It's a small, but this one is like industrial size, I believe. So I have one at home and it's small as well, and I have to just take out different sections each time.
Okay, that's it. So we use half of a cauliflower, guys. And it's cutting it up really fine, really tiny. Oh my gosh, it looks really good.
And it looks like rice.
And of course, there's always one. Give me a butter knife. There's always one little florent that doesn't want to, you know, move. So I'm gonna have to push it.
Push it real good.
Push it over. There it is. There it goes.
Wow.
It's chopping them up.
There it is.
So guys, also, when you do your cauliflower rice, you want to squeeze out the excess water because you don't want it to be mushy cauliflower rice. Yeah. You want it to be nice. Okay? So now that's done. We can
go back.
Look
how quick that was.
Let me show you.
Amazing. Look at
See, guys, cauliflower
it's
rice.
It's grainy, just like
so
rice.
Right now, I'm going to go put it on the fry pan on with 2 tablespoons of olive oil and season with salt and pepper while Mirage talks to you guys.
While Mirage talks. So, again, we use half the cauliflower. And you saw how much cauliflower that was that she's putting in the pot right now. It's amazing. Yes. Ew. Joselito, la fragancia. Hey, what's up? So yes, we're gonna get off. So we're really excited. Again, this recipe only takes about 5 minutes to make. And I like quick meals because I don't want to be in the kitchen all day. I got things to do. And I'm sure you have things to do. So, if, you know, when you do these kind of things, it's a one. It smells good. It's fresh. It's healthy, it's delicious, it's good for you, and that's what you want. You want to eat something that is going to sustain your, just keep you healthy. Because a lot of people, it's so easy to go out and buy McDonald's, but don't do that. Just
especially during these, the cold season, you got to eat healthy. You can't just eat anything and expect to stay healthy.
Yeah, so if you eat healthier, you'll stay healthier. And just so you know, sugar lowers your immune system. So just think about all the foods that we eat that have sugar in it. So it's easier for you to get sick. So during the Halloween time, I cheated. I'm gonna be honest, I cheated. You know, I bought Halloween candy because it was just the festive thing to do. You know what I'm saying? So just saying, so like when you eat all of those Halloween candies and stuff like that, it lowers your immune system. So understand, sugar is a poison and you gotta understand that. And how does that happen? Because it gets into your system and it lowers your immunity from being sick. So stay away from the sugar, eat healthy meals, and hopefully S&M Expo will help you with that. So,
and will inspire you to eat healthy.
Yeah. Ooh. Freddie Angelino said he had cauliflower rice with chicken and greens.
Oh, nice.
Green sauce.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yes, sweet. Squeeze it. Yes, Mr. Reach, squeeze it. Joselito, what's up? What's up, Sal?
Hey, Sal.
Kiko, what's up, Kiko? Johnny, what's up?
There's nothing like, you know, you're about to eat and you do the I'm about to eat dance, right?
Yeah, because all I had this morning was some oatmeal for breakfast, so.
And I had a side berry bowl.
We're doing good. What time is it?
Well, you both are sweet, and it's hard to stay away from you both.
29. Well, we're doing good. It takes 5 minutes for the rice to cook. So the cauliflower rice, and I'm going to season it with a little bit of pepper and a little bit of Himalaya salt. And also, if you would like a curry, which I know Mirage, you can put a little bit of curry in it. So what do you think? You want some curry in it?
No, let's do the I want to
just the okay.
I want to know how this recipe turns out. So, because curry is not like ketchup, you don't just throw it on everything. You know what I'm saying? So, but curry is good. That's what I'm eating. Oh yeah, it's about to eat dance by working curry. Yum. So, we're so happy that you guys are with us. And remember, we have our channels that we would like you to subscribe to and tell your friends about. And S&M Inspire and Susan_Mirage at Instagram. So we're on IG. Y'all should check out our IG pages and our TikTok pages.
Oh my God, TikTok guys. We got some funny stuff on TikTok. S-A-N-D-M Inspire. YouTube S&M Inspire. Guys, go like our YouTube channel. Some of the stuff that we have here, some of the stuff we don't have here is on our YouTube channel. So what you see here is different than what you see on YouTube also. We have stuff from here and stuff that's not from here. So guys, check it out. I'm so excited. So are you ready? You about ready for that?
So ready to eat.
So are you having yours with the rice? You having yours with the cauliflower rice?
I'm having it with the cauliflower rice. Okay. If it's ready. If not, I'll just keep playing.
Couple more seconds and it'll be ready, guys.
So, you want to know where to get the S&M shirts.
Ah.
So we will be putting that up for order soon. It only comes in one color right now. What color is it? is that? The fuchsia, right?
The
fuchsia? I think it only comes in the fuchsia. We'll check that out and we'll get back to you on our shirts. And we would love you guys to rock our shirts. That would be so awesome. And then when you rock our shirts, of course we'd like you to take a picture with them and then send it to us. And we'll put it on our website and we'll put it on our social media pages as well.
Ooh. So we're gonna taste a little bit to see what, do we need anything else in it before we put it on the plate.
It's hot.
It's hot, I know. Hot.
But let me cut it down. Good.
Good. But if you if you're someone that likes something sweet, you can put sugar in it.
Oh man, this is good. It really don't need sugar. Because remember, the
honey. Honey, fresh honey from here.
But the crushed tomatoes, just so you know, have the sugar in it already.
Oh my goodness.
Okay. Y'all understand what's about to go on. What's happening in my mouth right now. It's a whole party going on. This is party. Woo. Now I'll tell you, it's not spicy though. So if you want some extra spice, add the jalapeno or the spicy chili, more chili. We can make a little bit more spicy if you want.
A little more spicier?
Just a little bit more spicier.
So yeah. We have we have Scotch bonnet, guys, but this will be fine for me. You're
trying to kill us. No, I'm good. You can add more chili if you like. That's okay. It tastes very good. The combination of all the ingredients, look at that. Look at that right there. On the cauliflower rice.
My husband loves white rice, but he's gonna have to learn. We're being healthy in this family. Guys, thank you for watching.
Thank you. Cauliflower rice with a 3 bean chili. And again, this dish did not take forever. And not only that, but it's so tasty. It's an addictive kind of taste. You ever eat something and it tastes so good that you gotta have more and more and more? Well, I want some more right now. So again, guys, we wanna thank you. S&M Inspire, okay? S&M Inspire, okay? And again, we're gonna get back to you on that merchandise. Look at she.
Yeah, we'll get back. Let me say my prayer. Bless the Lord. You thank you what you're about to see from the body of Christ. Lord, amen. Oh, wow. The rice is awesome.
Right?
Wow. So, guys, we didn't even fix ourselves any water, but guys, we love you.
We love you.
We thank you for joining us today. 3 bean vegan chili. I'm gonna add some chicken to mine later. But you know, guys, it was good. All we want you guys to do is share love, give love, and go purchase Company B Love on all digital platforms, guys.
Yes, please support. Support us. Don't forget S&M Inspire. So on Instagram, it's Susan_Mirage, M-A-R-A-J. If you go to Facebook, it's S with the ampersand M and M Inspire. TikTok, S-A-N-D-M Inspire. YouTube, S&M Inspire. And Twitter, S&M Inspire with little ampersand. Check us out, follow us, share, subscribe to our page, please. And we will get back to you on the shirts. If you're interested in ordering shirts from us, send us a DM, let us know. And we will get back to you on that, okay? Thank you so much, love you guys.
I turned it on. Take care.
You can cut it off, babe.
Look at this. Enjoy.
We love you.
She said, add the chicken off camera, laugh out loud.
It's Friday.
That's right.
Friday, 1 o'clock.
Friday, 1 o'clock.
Friday, 1 o'clock.
Freestyle and old school.
Ooh, let's get it.